Having to get up at night over and over again to pee can really mess up our sleep. This is called nocturia, the need to urinate at night. And in this video, we're going to look at 5 science-based tips to reduce this problem. Our kidneys constantly filter impurities out of our blood, producing urine, which gradually fills our bladder. When the bladder is full, nerves coming out of it send signals to the brain, giving you that sense of urgency. We'll start with a more obvious tip, and then we'll move on to the lesser known ones. Since the goal is to not have a full bladder during the night, it's a good idea to avoid drinking large amounts of fluid in the hours leading up to your bedtime. Also, try to empty your bladder right before going to bed. This habit is known as preemptive voiding. It's basically nerd speak for get to that bladder before it gets to you. Tip number 2, avoiding drinks containing alcohol, caffeine, and also sugary drinks in the hours leading up to your bedtime can reduce nighttime urination because these drinks are diuretic, meaning they induce urine formation. By the same logic, if you happen to be taking diuretic meds, talk to your doctor about taking them earlier in the day so that you don't induce that full bladder during the night. Tip number 3, taking a hot bath before bed might reduce the need for nighttime urination. This one is more suggestive, it's less firmly established by the evidence, but there is some research suggesting that the exposure of the skin to warm temperature is anti-diuretic. So try it out, see if it helps. The interval the study suggests is 1 to 2 hours before bedtime, and also keep in mind the same principle during the night. Avoid cold temperatures in your bedroom. Tip number 4, if you have swelling in your legs, especially around the ankles, what's called edema, elevating your legs well before bedtime, like in the afternoon, for example, can help mobilize those fluids so you eliminate them earlier, like in the evening, instead of having to do that in the middle of the night. Also bear in mind that some conditions can cause nocturia, like BPH, for example. Benign prostatic hyperplasia, a benign enlargement of the prostate. The prostate sits right under the bladder, so if it enlarges, it can squeeze the bladder up and reduce its capacity, and it can also pinch the urethra, the tube that leads out from the bladder. So if the nocturia starts out of nowhere, you used to not have to pee at night, now you have to get up 2, 3, 4 times, and nothing changed. You are not drinking more fluids, you're not drinking closer to bed, you're not drinking some of those special drinks we talked about, you're not on any new meds, definitely talk to your doctor. And last but not least, tip number 5, there are some supplements that have been shown to reduce nocturia in clinical trials, like melatonin, for example. Melatonin is a hormone produced by a tiny gland in your brain called the pineal gland. And melatonin can induce sleep. The pineal gland has a really interesting scientific history because Descartes, the mathematician from the 1600s, believed that the pineal gland was the seat of the human soul. No word on that from neuroscientists, but it is true that when we can't sleep, it does feel a little bit like our soul has left our body. So maybe he wasn't so wrong after all. In a randomized, double-blinded, placebo-controlled trial, 2 milligrams of melatonin taken 1 hour before bedtime reduced the number of times people needed to get up to pee. Participants reported peeing twice a night at baseline. There was no significant change in the placebo group, and the melatonin group saw a reduction to about 50%. So one episode of getting up at night to pee. Another agent that has also been shown to reduce nocturia is a drug called desmopressin. 100 micrograms of desmopressin taken 1 hour before bedtime reduced the number of episodes of nighttime peeing from 3 to 2 in average, and this was also a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled trial. Before starting desmopressin, definitely talk to your doctor. It's not indicated for people who have abnormal levels of sodium, and it can affect sodium levels, so it's a good idea to keep an eye on your sodium if starting desmopressin. What about hydration? Is it true that we need to drink 8 glasses of water every day, or is that a myth? Check out this video where we address that exact question with science. And here's one on the best ways to lose weight. Low-carb diets compared to fasting. Check those out. I'll see you over there.